हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम मिस्टर संजय भड़के, प्रेजेंटली वर्किंग एज ए असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग एट तुलसीराम जी गायकवाड़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी नागपुर। स्टूडेंट, इन लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ रेल्स, वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ स्लीपर्स, व्हाट डू मीन बाय बलास्ट, which is a part of permanent wave. So today is your topic station and yard, which is one of the important topic in the subject of transportation engineering 2. So let's discuss about the syllabus and major content of the subject. The brief subject and syllabus we discussed in previous video lecture. So we know unit number 1 is related with the railway engineering, various classification of railway, what do you mean by permanent way, what do you mean by high speed track. So all these we are going to cover in unit number 1. Unit number 2, it is also the part of railway engineering which include the railway types and its functions, sleepers, types of sleepers, merit and demerits of creeps, coning of wheel, gradients, all this part we are going to cover in unit number 2. Unit number 3 is related with the points and crossing, station and yards, which is our today's topic, railway signaling and interlockings, various types of signals and its functions, various modern techniques of maintenance of railway tracks. Unit number 4 is related with the airport engineering, which include the details about the airport, airport obstructions, its laws, orientations, parking configurations, basic runway length, runway geometric designs. Unit number 5 is related with the airport layout and its classification. What do you mean by hangars, aprons, and various buildings? What are the various visual aids which can be used as a safety? What do you mean by taxiway? What do you mean by exit taxiway? What are the functions of air traffic control unit? So all this we are going to study in unit number 5. Finally, unit number 6 is related with the tunnel engineering, which include the tunnel survey, drainage, ventilation, lighting and lining of the tunnels. We have number of books, so you can use these books. A textbooks of railway engineering by S.C. Saxena and S.P. Arora. Railway track engineering by J.S. Mundry. Airport planning and design by S.K. Sharma and Khanna. Planning and design of airport by Mr. Robert. Air transportation planning and design by Satish Chandra. Also, there are number of national and international journals. Once you refer that journals, you will make the basic knowledge about the railway engineering, airport engineering and tunnel engineering. So these are some books which we recommended for your study. All these books are available in our laboratory and library also. So student, today we are going to discuss about the station and yards. We know in the railway engineering, station and yards play a very important roles. We all are familiar with the platform and we all are familiar with the stations. So we know where there is number of publics, will gather on the platform. That particular area is called as a station, and a particular place from which there is a transformation of various types of goods or material, that particular area is called as the adz. A railway station or a railway broad station, and often shortened to just station, is a railway. A railway provides this facility where trains regularly stop to load or unload the passenger and any others material. So where we are doing the loading and unloading of passenger or material, that particular area called as the station and yards. You can see this picture. This is a particular picture which is related with the station. In this picture, you can see the various parts of the railway station, which include various gate, various parking, orientations, configurations, yards, and many mores. What are the various purpose of railway station? Normally, we are using the railway station for the exchange of passenger and goods, for the control of train movements, to enable the trains on a single line track or to cross from opposite direction, to enable the falling express train to overtake, for taking the diesel or coal and water for the locomotives. Basically, here is the meaning of locomotive means engine. Normally, these engines are classified as a steam engine, diesel engine, and electric engine. So nowadays, we are normally using the electric engine. So this way, there are many purpose of the railway station. If there is any repairing work related to the engine or locomotive, so in that case, we have provided this type of facilities on the railway stations. So these are listed various purpose which normally we are doing. Next, what are the various types of stations? The stations are classified as a wayside station, junction station, and terminal station. So friends, many time we are confused. What do you mean by junctions? What do you mean by terminals? And what do you mean by wayside station? So these are the types of the station, and these are classified as per the requirements and facility provided by particular stations. Next, what do you mean by wayside station? In this type of arrangement are made for crossing or overtaking the trains. Wayside stations are of the following types: halt station, flag station, and crossing station. We know many time if any fast going train want to cross the another train, so there should be the marking on a particular station where this activity will be carried out, and that particular station is called as the wayside station, which gives the way to fast moving station or train. Halt station. A halt is a small station, usually unstaffed and with few or no facilities. In some cases, trains stop only on request when passenger on the platform indicate that they wish to board, or passenger on the train inform the crew that they wish to alight. So normally, halt station are the small station. If there is any emergency work or if there is any maintenance in the locomotive, and in that case, if anybody want to stop, so in that case, we have using this halt station. So you can see this is the cross section of the halt station. Here the railway wave line is shown, and in the front of railway wave line, one platform is provided, which is near about 250 meter long, and in both side is name board is shown. So this small station is called as the halt station.
Then what do you mean by the flag station?
The flag station describes a stopping point at which trains stop only on as a need or request basis. I already discussed that if there is any emergency or any request, in that case we are using the flag station. This station have no overtaking or crossing facility and arrangement to control the movement of train. This station have a building staff and telegraph facility. So we know that the small station is called a horse station, and flag station is one station where we are providing some facility like building staff and telegraph facility in case of any emergency. In some flag station they have sliding in the form of loops also. So you can see this is the cross section of a flag station. So it is about 250 meter long, and a railway wave line is also shown there. In this flag station various types of buildings are staffs are available. Next, crossing station. So we already discussed that if in any emergency case, if one train want to cross another train, in that case we are using the crossing station. They are provided with the modern crossing facility, and in this type of crossing station a additional loop lines is provided. Generally the train to be stopped is taken on the loop line and through train is allowed to pass on the main line. So what is the main function of crossing station? To provide an additional loop line in case of emergency crossing of the train. So you can see in this cross section there are two types of lane. One is the main lane, second one is loop lane. So in case of emergency we are using this loop lane for the crossing of fast moving trains. Also various types of buildings and station attachment is shown in this station. It is also provided with modern signals and sign to avoid any type of accidents. Now next is junction and stations. A junction station lines from three or more direction meet. The station where a branch line meet the main line are known as a junction. The arrangement in the junction stations are facility for interchange of traffic between the main and branch line, facility to clean and repair the compartments of the train, facility for the goods siding, engine shed, turntable, etc. So normally junction station is one of the big station where we can carry out the various types of maintenance work related to the train or locomotives. If you want to clean your train, if you want to take some water or other material, so you can get this material from the junction station. Number of main lines, loop lines are provided on the junction station where various train can be rest for a time. This is the platform of the junction station. Various loop line, main lines, branch lines, referring centers, goods sheds are shown in the layout. So you can see how this platform are attached to each other, how they are provided the crossing line and loop lines in the pictures. Next is terminal station. It is a station where a railway line or one of its branch terminates. Following are the various facilities are available in the terminal station. Watering, cleaning services,
turntable for the change of the directions of engine, for dealing with the goods circulating area, ticket counters, restaurants and other facilities are available in the terminal station. So here we can say that terminal station is the one of the station where all type of facilities are available, and in case of any emergency we can use this terminal station fully. You can see this is the one layout of the terminal station where number of tracks are available: track number 1, platform number 1, track number 2, platform number 2, track number 4, platform number 4, and vice versa. So these are the terminal station where number of trains will come, number of train will rest. So it is are in big size and many tracks are available on the terminal station. All type of facility we are providing to the passenger on terminal stations. Next is yard. So student, now we discuss about the various types of station, its subtypes, what are the various types of facilities are available, and how these stations are classified. So our next point is the yard. We know normally yard is the particular area which we are providing on the station and which we are using for the transfer of various types of goods or other materials. This area consisting of a network of railway track, siding and shed for storing, maintaining and joining engine and carriage. A yard is defined as a system of track laid within the defined limit for a various purpose, such as receiving, the sorting and dispatch of vehicles. We know through railway there are number of goods are transferred from one place to another place. When it reached to a particular station, it should be stored, it should be divided. So all this activity will be carried out on the yard, and that particular area is one of the safe area which is covered with all type of facility. You can see this picture. This particular picture is called as the railway yard. You can see is a number of rolling stock vans, good vans are there, and we are using this type of yards for the store and transfer of various types of goods. So yard is one of the big thing where number of tracks are available, number of vans are available. You can see in this picture there number of stored buildings are also available for the safety of materials and good. Then what are the types of yards? Yards are again divided into number of type. The first yard is called as the passenger yard, second yard is called as the good yards, third yards is called as the marshalling yard, and next is locomotive yards. So as per the uses of particular yard or area, or as per the various types of facility provided by particular area, these yards are classified in following numbers. So student, this way today we discuss about the basic terminology of station and yards, and I hope you understand about the basic difference which is between the station and yards. In next class we deeply discuss about what do you mean by passenger yard, what do you mean by marshal yard, what do you mean by locomotive yards, and vice versa. Thank you. Thank you.